Hi guys, greetings from Bulgaria. I'm Anton, and I'm really glad that the friends from Lambda Test invited me to do this video series about xUnit and how you can use it to create Selenium tests with C#. As I said, I'm Anton Angelov. I'm CTO of Automate the Planet. Maybe you read many of my articles on my blog. Also, I'm author of three books. Maybe the most famous one is Design Patterns for High Quality Automated Tests in Java and C#. So in this course, there will be seven modules. The first module that we're going to talk in this video will be what is xUnit, how you can get started, how we can migrate from version 1 to version 2. Then we're going to talk about how you can set up and create a new project in Visual Studio. What packages do you need to install? How you can run your test through command line. Then in the third video, we're going to talk about the different attributes that we use in xUnit to write automated tests. And we are going to create our first test with Selenium. Also, we are going in video 5 to run the test in parallel. In the sixth module, we're going to talk about the different, how you can basically run the test with many parameters, again, for Selenium tests. And our seventh module will be about how to do cross-browser testing with xUnit and combine it with Lambda test. And Lambda tests has many awesome features like reporting, walks, video recording for our tests. And as you will see, it makes the cross-browser testing really easy. So first, let's begin. What is xUnit? Well, xUnit is free and open source unit testing tool, one of the latest and greatest for .NET development. It's written by the original inventor of JUnit version 2. It can be integrated pretty well with C#, F#, Visual Basic .NET, and other .NET languages. Of course, for this video tutorials, we're going to use C#. Not to mention that basically you can use .NET framework or the latest .NET core for cross-browser, cross-platform development. Also, it integrates well with all of the popular .NET integrated environments and popular tools such as Sharper, CodeRush, TestDriven.net, and Xamarin. And last but not least, it's part of the .NET Foundation. Here you can see on the screen a sample test structure. And as you can see, it's pretty straightforward and lightweight compared to other unit testing frameworks in .NET, such as MS Test and JUnit. You need only a single attribute on top of a method to mark it as a test, and we don't need anything else. As we're going to talk later, the fact attribute basically marks your tests, that basically this test without any parameters. And later we use the special assert class to make some verifications. Now, what are the advantages and why you should care about xUnit.NET compared to other unit testing frameworks? First, xUnit.NET is much more extensible when compared to other .NET test frameworks. You can customize and write custom functionality for not equal, equal, does not contain, contains, etc., or any other related attributes. They basically change the annotations instead of the test method or test attribute. As you saw in the example, we use the fact annotation, or in case when you need to use many parameters, we use the theory attribute, but in later videos, we'll going to talk much more about it. Then the second thing, it's the better resolution of the tests. There are many other under the hood changes. But basically, a new class is again instantiated for the next method, and the same sequence is followed. And better isolation, they can be, you know, as the tests are more isolated, they can be executed in any order without the need to be worried about the effect of one test on the another tests. Hence, it eliminates the dependency between different test methods. Also, you will notice the absence of setup and teardown attributes, or basically the test initialization and test cleanup, which we have in xUnit and MS test. Here, basically the inventors decided that basically these attributes and methods they lead to a lot of code duplication. This is why right now in xUnit.net we use constructor for the initialization logic and implementation of a disposable interface for test cleanup. Also, another advantage is the minimal set of attributes. Many of you know, the popular attributes in the other unit testing frameworks are deprecated or combined in order the framework to be more user-friendly. And last but not least, instead of using the expected exception attribute, now we have this generic method assert trolls, which eliminates many of the drawbacks related to this. Now, let's talk, if you already have many tests written in version 1, what you need to do to migrate to version 2, the latest version with the new features. Well, it's relatively easy. You need to uninstall the existing NuGet package and then install the latest version 2. And also, previously there was this xUnit extensions NuGet package where it brings a lot of methods. Right now, you don't need it. In case you have other exceptions, you can go to xUnit.net docs test migration. There is a really great article where you can see the images and everything step by step. And the most important part here is that if you, in case you have compilation errors, there are some descriptions what you need to do to eliminate them. Thank you for watching. In the next video, we'll continue with the next module, and I will show you how to create projects from scratch in Visual Studio. In case of any question, you can write to support Lambda Test or contact me in LinkedIn. I'll be happy to help you. Also, if you want to increase, even improve more your knowledge, you can visit the Lambda Test blog. They have a really great article, really detailed about xUnit and other popular technologies. Or you can contact the community directly. And also, if you want to earn a certification, you can visit this link. And you can get recognized. Thank you. See you in the next video.